Hello, everybody. My name is Maxim Ivarov. I am a senior engineer at Linaro. And today I will talk about our work, what we do in Linaro. And probably it will be interesting for you. So I will talk about Latch Reference Platform as a development environment for the secure boot. So first of all, I need to say what is Latch Reference Platform. Latch Reference Platform is considered to be a reference platform for supported industry standards for Linux operation system. And the primary purpose is to build operation system for Internet of Things devices and for H type of devices. And adhering the specification for which are related to boot or secure boot or on things which we do implementation. So it's a UEFI, UBBR, PCI, SCPI, and so on. So as the distributive we do, you can take a look at the picture, and it's a collection of different applications. It's a kernel, it's a firmware, and it's a secure application. So a lot of work we spend to just make all this chain work, because you know that integration is a quite complex process where one apps depends on the other apps, libraries have some specific version, the kernel have version, and all of that should match and work together. During the LHRP, we work on a different open source project. So it's our playground for some of our projects related to LHRP, like Trusted Substrate. And so LHRP is a vertical distributive and for full open source code. So we use OpenEmbed to compile everything. So we compile firmware, kernel, all applications, KMO virtual machine, which we use, and whatever. So we have full control of source code, and we can patch any applications, and we can satisfy any dependencies across the applications during the build. We have CI system to test our features. So once we change something, CI automatically starts, compiles everything, flashes target, boot them, and do tests. So on the while do development, we focus on the specifications to do the proper implementation. I listed the primary our specification. It's a UEFI ARM system ready, BSA specification, a embedded boost base boot requirements, ARM boot requirements, device tree specification, and platform security architecture. So this is the the common our specification, and links are clickable in my presentation, so you can download and use these links. We work on such open source project as U-Boot. It's a UEFI support inside the U-Boot. QEMO, TFA, Opti, Linux kernel, and security things which is across the Linux kernel, Opti, and apps. So it's a TFA, CLinux, IMA, Parsec. And also one of feature which I will discuss today, it's rootFS encryption with a TPM device. Our usual workflow, it's we work from OpenEmbedded, do some build, Then we do changes. We try to upstream these and take these changes back. So we use open source community as much as possible, and we try to always send our work to the open source and get it merged to upstream. For LedgeRP, we have two type of images which we define, and one image is related to IoT devices, and one image is related to gateway devices. So the difference is a set of applications. IoT image is very similar to Fedora IoT package set, and the gateway image, it's an image to include network protocols, PTP, OpenNavno, and our applications, which are related more for gateways. And both image has containers and OS3 update support. So if we talk about secure boot, we can take a look at this picture and how the UEFI secure boot looks like. So bootloader in our case, it's U-boot, or it can be EDK2, but in EDK2 secure boot already implemented, so we work on U-boot. So it has some storage for UEFI variables. So EFI variables, it's variables which store keys for verifying the signature of loaded image. So in our case, a loaded image is first image which EFI spec loads, so it's a boot A64 EFI, and we just place kernel. And that kernel, once U-boot booted, should be verified with the certificate which is integrated inside the U-boot. So once we build the kernel, we sign the kernel image with a certificate. And that signed kernel image will be on each load verified by U-boot. If signature matches, then U-boot will boot this kernel, so it will jump to kernel code. If signature doesn't match, then U-boot will reject to load this kernel. From the left side of this picture, we have Opti. Opti is a trusted operation system which run in secure world on the CPU, and inside Opti, we can have a storage for the certificates. So primary key and key, DB and DBX, we can store inside the Opti, and it will be tamper resistant. Root-of-S encryption. We use a tool named Clevis. I will talk about the Clevis few slides later. Now, just the picture what the whole system looks like. So, from left side, we have some TPM driver. TPM driver will provide DFTPM and Linux kernel, and now. After that, we want to boot to initramfs. And initramfs should decrypt our rootfs before we mount the root. So TPM in that case is required because we want to follow the secure boot specification, and we want to stay and we want to defend ourselves on the attack where the disk can be removed from your machine, or you can replace a different firmware or different kernel. So TPM is a key feature in that scheme, so that TPM itself, like your hardware, your firmware, bootloader, and the kernel will be on the same security line, and only that can decrypt your root file system. So if we look from a programmer point of view to the application stack, so it's decrypt in the kernel, which crypts and decrypts block devices. So from it will be also some TPM driver. TPMTs, for example, if we emulate TPM inside a virtual machine in QEMU, for example, or it will be OptiFTPM, OptiTPM if we emulate TPM inside the OptiOS, or it will be driver for hardware TPM. So it will be crypt setup tools, TPM2 tools. On top, there is a Clevis application and some scripts in the NitroFS which will assist to crypt or decrypt root partition. So to store the keys do encryption, we use Lux. Lux is a Linux unified key setup. Lux itself, it's a specification for disk encryption, and it has implementation inside Linux kernel. So it's a dmcrypt driver and crypt setup utilities. So on the picture, I just showed that how Lux header looks in the very simple way. So we have some disk. On the disk, there is a Lux header for some specific partition. And inside the this header, there is a place for key slots. So you can store some certificates or keys to decrypt your partition inside that slots. Trusted platform model. So what is itself for people who are not familiar with it? So usually TPM is a microcontroller, typically designed to perform some cryptographic operations. They can encrypt, decrypt things, and usually they are slower than CPU, and doing the but the keys tied to the TPM itself, so they just do the only encryption decryption, so it's not general purpose CPU, so it's a very specific the hardware. Usually access to this hardware is done through some or registers or I2C protocol or some serial protocol, SPI, something like that. TPM has a serial of PCRs. So PCR, it's a platform configuration register. So it can record system state. Most of PCRs are resettable unless you reboot. And of course, the PCR can seal and unseal key based on specific PCR values. So you can store and fetch the key inside the PCR. On this slide, it's picture from Microsoft documentation for a measured boot. And the idea is that this picture would show of the secure boot. So on each stage, from bootloader to firmware and to driver to applications, the PCRs are extended with some hash functions. And finally, we use a result of PCR to decrypt the system. So if you just change one element in the system, your PCR will not match the expected, and you will unable to decrypt your use this PCR for decryption. If we talk about decryption root FS, or use this PCR values to do something else. This slide shows how to use TPM. For example, we can, with the following commands, we can create a persistent sealing object to seal inside the TPM and use it to seal a random byte sequence as a disk key. So I will not just follow the all command and options and whatever. I just wanted that probably first and the last bloodiest command, that object ID will be at address like 1x810102, and we will generate some key and store them. And now we can store the key which we generated for TPM in Lux key slot. So, and the first command will just install this, and the second command will unseal the key, open crypt setup with that unsealed key, and mount root file system to /mnt. And I added on this slide, I added interactive link. If you want to read more documentation about that command options and how that works. So that's the key idea. Now we have a Clevis. Clevis is a Red Hat application which used for pluggable encryption, and they use it in different scenarios. To decrypt virtual machine, to protect them, and real machine and whatever. So it it's a wrapper on top of TPM tools. It supports three different modes. It's a mod one named TAN. TAN, it's when you need to check your encryption against the remote server. So you just send HTTP request and you get response and work on that. So second mode is TPM2. It's actually what we want to use, and we want to use this plugin for Clevis. And third one is Shamir secret sharing. So it's a technology when you split the key on the serial key, on the several pieces, and to restore the whole key, you just need to decrypt all these pieces and collect the final key for the decryption. So it's like decryption in the some kind of, you can use a recursion or just a decryption in pieces. So this slide has a link on GitHub for Clevis, and this tool very simplifies the command which I showed above to encrypt in decrypt. So with Clevis, just encrypt and use looks open, so you can use the amount. It's just free comments. In the first comment, we just format some partition, and we say that this partition will be looks. On the second comment, we bind partition to our TPM2 device, and we say that we can use following PCR IDs, and we want to store these in, for example, slot 1, minus S1, so it can be any slot. And for on the decryption state, we just say that Clavius Lux pass our partition minus slot 1, and Clavius will read this slot and understand that it needs a TPM assistant to fetch this key in the TPM, and it will decrypt it, and we will pass to clip setup looks open the key which was unsealed from the TPM. So in the down in the script, I post a NitramFS script which I wrote to encrypt rootFS partition and decrypt it. So encryption happens on the first boot, and decryption happens on second and following boots. So if we write encrypted disk, so looks header looks like that. So we can use crypt setup looks dump instruction, and in one we can, for example, see that I activated slot one. It's when we created looks partition and typed password. So I typed password ledge for our reference, and inside the slot three, I just wrote the TPM encryption key. When we do looks open, under partition which we encrypted, there will be decrypted rootFS, which you can just mount and boot from it. So this partition will appear automatically, and you can reference to dev mapper rootFS and mount it. On this slide, I added the links or on our work on a meta ledge and our build ledge UE manifest, so you can build on Open Embedded, browse of docs how to build it. Posted links to CI, one CI for release and one CI for dev. And for dev, usually with something, we can break something, after that we can repair something. But I think it's a good reference to start, actually, start from docs and probably start from release and just test the features which we implemented. So, and how to get involved in a project? It's an open source project working under Linara membership. So use just Linara contacts to contact Linara and join to us. And I know that a lot of people work on security boot things, and to do things together, I think it's more easier and more effective. That's all what I wanted to say, and I think inside the time frame. So if there are any questions, I would like to answer. Okay, I think I do not see any questions on at least my web. web interface that doesn't show anything. So thank you for listening to me, and goodbye.